Human. Jola no bad, Jaba Raso. Jola no bad, Jaba Raso. Uba le par, Pada Raso. Take it, vale par, Pada Raso. Yeah. Wozu shalala, telling kati. Eating kalala, lani pati. Wozu shalala, telling kati. Eating kalala, lani pati. Swagging over. Call me your swagging over. Casanova. I like how she call me your swagging over. We run in the city for sure. What? I'm participating in my level.
No, you're not ready. You are ready as fuck, man. No, I'm really feeling the love and the style and the smile. So, a lot of energy that I'm certainly missing a little bit in Europe. But in Europe also the weather is colder, so I think here it's more like it's cozy, yeah. Listen, at the end, for me a sneakerhead it's not to have like 700 pairs or even if I just have one Yeezy. He's for me a sneakerhead because he's loved the passion. Perhaps like he was like saving money 3 or 4 years to grab this one holy grail, and that has my lot of respect.
Being into sneakers is actually really important just for your life and your body. Like, if you're going to be running, then it's nice to have a good pair of sneakers to make sure you don't mess up your knees, you don't mess up, like, your back. It's a serious thing, you know. And then also you just see, like, a lot of ladies wearing pumps and things. And it's actually serious because they're working 8 to 10 hours a day and they don't have comfortable footwear. And it's not even a joke, fam. Like, at the end of the day, they're messing up their backs and they're just unhappy, and it could just be better and easier if they just had proper footwear. So it starts with that. Not about the hype. Like, yes, it became a hype at a point, but if you are someone that understands the beauty and craft of what goes into making a sneaker, it becomes more, you know? So I think it's... yeah, there's levels to it, and we've always been ready to have good footwear. So it's not about like, are we ready, aren't we ready? It's just a thing at the end of the day that we need it. So the fact that we're getting more accessibility to it through spaces like Sneakerness, through Sneaker Exchange, I think it's super important.
All the Yeezy Boosts, the Air Max Ones, the Jordans, everything. We know there's some points to approve for sure, but the brands, the bigger brands, they know we are here. So we'll take from that, do our learning, come back stronger next year.
So I have to say, number 2, MX 97s, Undefeated. So it's a collab between Undefeated and Nike. For lack of better words, the Gucci colorway, classic silhouette, you know, air bubble. Who doesn't like 97? Look, the sneaker I have on right now is also from 1997, the Spiridons. So I'm about 90s, the 90s kick, bro. Number 2. Number one. Nike Air Yeezy 1 original colorway. I actually have these. I have them in two colorways, but this is probably my favorite sneaker of all time. It's the AEZ. I mean, bro, no one's done that silhouette before. Strap over, the support on the ankle. These glow in the dark, like, so you have the swoosh that glows, the sole that's also glow. Amazing sneaker, bro. Like, I mean, just look at it. You ask exactly with the pink on the insides. Yeah, I probably wear them like twice a year, just because I don't want to mess them up. Like, so if this was my size and if I could afford it, I would buy the sneaker again. Every time. I got them when they came out, so they were like 3K. I don't know what they cost now. This is probably like 40 grand. I'm not sure. We're gonna ask them. Sorry. 35K. So these are 35K. Yeah. Number one.